Hey everybody, this is Gilbert, and today I'll be playing M-Beer on Light Chess on the 15-minute 2 time control. So e4, e5. So against e4, I just like to play e5, keep it simple, best by test, right? So we have a Ruy Lopez. So the thing about this is that even though this is being attacked, this pawn on e5, it doesn't mean it can be win that easily. It can be won that easily. So I like to play a6 against this, just to challenge the intentions. If we have this capture, like we do here, a lot of lower players like to capture. If we get this capture, we have this nice fork. So now the question is, how should I defend this pawn? So let's see. There's bishop to d6. Bishop d6 is interesting because it gets me lined up against the enemy king, and so once I play f5, this bishop might open up. So it looks like a good option. But what do I do against d4? Should I just capture in that case? Well, that would just open me up. If capture, pawn push, would I really be okay with retreating? Yeah, it seems fine to me. Just go for it. So we're gonna capture, and now our bishop has more scope, but I realize that this pawn can be pushed. So I need to attend to the g7 pawn. Now that this bishop is no longer on f8, we need to do something about that. Possibly queen to f6 looks good, but doesn't that run into a fork? So the thing about queen f6 is that we have couple different threats here. Bishop to g5, pawn push, and it's a little hard. I see we have some tactics here. Let's see if I capture. And the king captures. So it doesn't seem anything to be lining up yet. But there could be some potential tactics there. Maybe bishop to e7 here looks okay. It's a retreating move, yes, but no, bishop e7 ignores g7. So what am I doing there? F6 possibly? F6, pawn push, capture. F6, what am I doing against e5? F6, e5. What do I do there? Am I just retreating to e7 at that point? I mean, at that point, I'd have some stability. So it looks alright. Yes, this is weakened, so I need to be careful about that. I need to be careful about this. It's gonna take me a long time to get castled. I may not have played this right out of the opening. He's putting some pressure on me. Maybe knight to e. Maybe knight e7 looks okay. Possibly c5. C5 just to get the queen to move out of the way. I might have some tactics here if I play bishop to g4, trying to remove the defender of the queen. So bishop to e4. What am I doing against e5? Capture. Capture, check. So I'm not really liking that. So what about c5? I need to find some candidate moves. C5, queen to d5. Doesn't seem that great. So after knight to e7, what am I doing against e5? Am I just simply capturing? It doesn't look that great. Am I just simply playing for this? Just castle kingside? Yeah, I'm not really sure how that's looking. But e5 is hitting fast, and I need to do something about that. Yeah, I need to get it in the way of the e-file. This rook is too active for me right now. So against e5, I'm just gonna play fx. I know it doesn't look that great. It kind of steps into some pins, possibly. But that's kind of what happens. So I'm forced to take. Knight captures. Is there anything I missed? Yeah, just get out of the way. See how open my position is? I kind of don't like it. Should I just go into the corner? There's some weakness. If I play king to h8, this knight can come in. Kind of don't like that. So maybe knight to d5 is the way to go. Knight to d5, getting ready to play bishop e6. It's in the way. I kind of like this. It looks like my position is stabilizing now a little bit. Possibly bishop to e6 is a move here. Capturing doesn't look great. This capture doesn't look very great. Just inviting another piece to play. What about a move like queen to f, queen to f6, threatening to capture on f. That might be a tactic here. Let's look at that. So we have queen to f6. Attacking f7, attacking the knight. Possibly queen here is going to be a response. How am I responding to that? Looks good. So if this knight captures, I don't have to respond right away. I have an in-between move. There we go. Who's defending that rook? Nobody is. Let's capture. This is game over. So, looks like we won. Good game. Let's look at the analysis board. I didn't like how I was out of the opening. Let's take off the engine for a little bit. So, this is all natural. But now we come to this point. How do I defend this pawn? Let's see. Maybe f6 right away. I know in some lines we get this kind of we get something like rook over, bishop out, c3, knight out. This looks common, but what did I play? I played bishop to d6. I don't like bishop to d6. Did I consider bishop g4? Bishop g4 just pins. What are we doing against this kind of thing? Kingside's weakened. So I don't think this is good for white. So it looks like bishop g4 may have been the move. Let's see what the engine says. Yeah, bishop g4 looks good. Yeah, so we have f6, but bishop g4, that's where it's at. I mean, pinning this knight. Oftentimes in these e4 games, you need to kind of play h3 in order to actually stop this pin. This pin is pretty bad. But that's not what happened. We get d4, and I was thinking here that this is good for my bishop, but just look at this pawn. It's so easy to advance. I don't like queen takes d4. I thought maybe pawn was gonna advance. I mean, you can always take with the knight later, right? So I play f6. Is f6 the way to go? Yeah, so the engine likes f6. And now rook to e1. Just getting ready to play this. How do I respond? Honestly, this is about to open up, so I need to do something. Oh, look at that, moves like c5, but I don't know, it just didn't strike me as very good. I saw this kind of move. You're just inching closer to my king. Didn't like it. It seemed like a weakness to me. So knight to e7 is like, I guess just blocking the e-file is a good thing to do. E5 is played. Am I supposed to capture? I have to, right? Yeah, so it looks like the engine agrees. We're kind of even-ish now. By this point, by just releasing all attention to the center, my king's able to get safe, and my pieces aren't doing that bad. So yeah, blocking is the right thing to do here. Like I was mentioning, we don't want to get into a tactic like this, where we have to sack. We have to lose the exchange. No. We have to blunt. We have to blunt the attack. So what I liked here is that I noticed that there was some tension on this square. I was thinking after queen f6 we would have something like queen d4. See how that defends both? I wasn't really sure what I was doing gonna do here. I was looking at moves like if I capture, rook would just capture. But that allows for pins, possibly. See how we have this pin going on? Is there any tactics? Are there any tactics here? I mean, let's see. What does the engine think? Yeah, just even if this doesn't do anything for me. So here I was looking at this, right? This says I'm up a minor piece. How exactly? Ah, okay, so I need to get the queen off of this defensive square. See how now the queen's overloaded? So what about, go back. So you just like knight blocks. It makes sense that we would have this bishop opposed to queen. Okay. But my opponent didn't notice that. He just saw, oh, I win a pawn. You can't be too eager to win pawns here. See how I only have one defender to two attackers? But the thing is, you have to worry about this king. I guess he didn't notice there was a fort. Maybe he saw that I was attacking the knight, but he thought he'd have enough time to defend it eventually. But no, it didn't work out that way. Well, that's all I have for you guys. I hope you guys like this video. Stay tuned.